Hello all, we'll be making a musical tube model. These tubes fitted into this frame will produce musical octave. Let us know first the material we need for this project. You can easily notice that these are 8 tubes of different length. They'll be producing SA-RE-GA-MA-PA-DHA-NI-SA music for us. This is a nylon rod which we'll use to strike these musical tubes. These are 4 bushes. We have a wooden board having marking at 4 corners. You can easily notice this marking. Then we have these long bolts with nuts and little smaller bolts with nuts. We also have these nylon threads. We'll need them to fix pipes here in the frame. This wooden base, just to place it under this bigger base while drilling a hole into the corners of this. Along with this material, we also need some tools. We'll need this hand drill, we'll need a screwdriver, we may need a scissors, we'll need this nut holder. We also need this kind of sketch pen. We may need some water into this cup. So along with this, we'll make a working model of musical tubes. Let us begin with preparation of a board. As you know, there are 4 markings at 4 corners of this board. Using a hand drill machine, we have to make drills at all 4 corners. This is a drill bit fixed into this. You have to make sure that this is tight. Once that is clearly seen, we can begin. As we'll drill it, we should not make a drill into the table. So place this kind of wooden board under this and hold this machine using its either this handle or this handle. Press it down and start rolling your right hand in clockwise direction. Once the drill is done, you can take this drill bit out by doing it anti-clockwise. This comes out. So the drill is made at one corner. We have to make similar drills at rest of the 3 positions as well. Let us now fix these bushes under this board at 4 corners. It has one flat surface and one surface with a kind of hole. Use this flat surface on top, and using a long bolt and nut, we have to fix it into these corners. So first remove this nut from this bolt. Pass this bolt through this hole and also pass this flat surface, keeping this flat surface up. This bolt is passed into this bush. Insert this nut and start tightening it using your fingers. Like this, then come on this side and you can use a screwdriver and keep fixing it slowly till you completely tighten it. We have to repeat this at all 4 corners so that this base will be ready with 4 bushes at 4 corners. Let me tell you how to use a nut holder
for fixing this nut. Once you start this, you can use your fingers till this keeps going in like this. But once that limit is over, you will need to use this nut holder. Insert this nut holder in this. The nut gets locked, and from the other side, by holding this nut holder by your finger, you can just screw it till it is fully tightened. This is the easier way of fixing these bushes to the board.
Now, this board is ready with four bushes fixed at four corners. So this can be used for fixing of frame as a next step. Now on this board, you have to fix this frame. Place it here first. You have to take this approximately in the center. Make sure that it is properly centered from both sides. Look at the distance. Take a sketch pen. Mark these points. You can also use a pencil. Once these four points are marked, you have to again make a drill at these four points like we did for four corners. Now the board is ready with these four drills. These drills are made using same drill machine with the same technique that we use for corner four drills. Once it is done, take the frame, you have to place it here, let someone support it for a while, and these bolts and nuts are also given in the kit. We have four such bolts and nut pairs. Pass them through these holes, matching them to the holes of the board. And you have to lock these, the nuts from the bottom. So this frame will stand upright and firm. We have created this frame. This frame is mounted on this wooden base using these four bolts fixed from bottom with a nut and nut holder and a screwdriver. So make sure that this is firmly standing on the board. Now next step is to place or mount these eight metal tubes in these eight hooks using this thread. So they will be mounted in this descending order. We have this thread. There are three such threads given. Just you can use one which is longer. We have to pass this thread through these holes, and this is to be looped, and we have to fix it here into this hook. So likewise, we have to mount eight such metal tubes. This box also has come as a part of this packaging. Place this box in exactly in the center of this frame. We have to make sure that the hole should come up and this side is towards bottom. You have to place this, rest it on this, and you have to make a loop of this thread. You have to pass this thread finally through these holes, and you have to tie a knot here in this hook. So cut this thread approximately of the size which is sufficient to make a loop of this pipe and this hook. this all eight to be placed like this, so that the bottom line of all eight tubes will be at the same level. So make sure that you place all eight one by one, but before that you should start inserting threads into each one of them.
We have made eight such pieces. The length of each thread is approximately 25 centimeters or even little less than that, say about 10 inches. So using one long thread, you can make these eight pieces. We have to pass this end of a thread through both the holes, which are opposite to each other, into this metal pipe. To do this, one technique is just dip it in water, just straighten it a little bit, and then this can easily pass through both the holes which are opposite to each other. If this technique is not very handy, then we can also use a technique of using a steel wire. Place this in between this steel wire at the center. Just fold this steel wire and twist it a little bit. This twisted steel wire should then be passed through these two holes, and you can find that the thread is easily passed through. Once this is done, either using water technique or steel wire technique, finally you have to place this on the frame and fix this into the hook. And you have to make good knots here till it is fixed. So you have to, of course, make at least two such knots. One and the second one. Make sure that this remains in place. So the first one is ready. In the same descending order, you have to mount all eight tubes into the frame. Once this will be freely suspending like this. This thread is given extra with the kit. So let this extra thread also go to the school. So in case if this thread breaks, they can replace and make the frame once again ready with all eight tubes. Let us complete this now. We have fixed now these eight pipes using thread on top. They are almost at the same level in the bottom. We may have to cut these extra threads to give it a neat look. Finally, we need to fix this nylon rod to the frame, which will be used to strike on these eight pipes to produce SA-RE-GA-MA-PA-DHA-NI-SA, that complete octave. We have to pass this thread through this hole of the rod, dip it in water, and once it is wet, you can easily pass it through the hole. You can pass this through this nylon tube either using this dipping technique, water technique, or you can also use this metal wire technique. Just make a knot here, one and two, and You have to fix the other end of this. You have to fix the other end of that pipe, nylon pipe here. So your striker is ready. You can strike it and produce musical notes. Listen to them carefully.